Hey guys, it's Bree the Coupon Queen and welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. So today what I'm gonna do is a little bit of gardening. I really wanna increase the size and amount of herbs and vegetables that I have for two reasons. One, it gives me something to do while we're all trying to stay at home. And two, it's a lot healthier and more convenient if I can just go to my backyard and get some squash or some carrots or something like that. So that is what we are going to be doing today. If you're not subscribed yet, make sure you hit the subscribe button in the bottom right-hand corner and the notification bell. I will be doing another giveaway for you guys. It will be posted Sunday in my CVS haul video. That is the video that you guys are gonna wanna watch so you can enter my newest giveaway. Seems like the consensus is a $10 gift card. So for the winner, you'll be able to choose where you want that gift card. That way, in case you don't have a CVS near you or Walgreens, Amazon, whatever, you guys can choose where you want that $10 gift card to be from. So make sure that notification bell is clicked so when I do post that video, you guys can watch it and enter my newest giveaway. So I went to Walmart a couple weeks ago because I knew I wanted to do some gardening and plant more plants in my backyard. I also have to do a backyard makeover because my backyard is like a mess. It's super dead. All the grass keeps dying. Totally over it. So eventually I want to totally redo my backyard and make it a lot cuter. So when I went to Walmart, I picked up a couple different vegetables that we are going to be planting. You can get them from the dollar store as well. I've been to the dollar store a couple weeks ago and they only had like two or three different vegetables left available. The supplies that they had were really limited. So that's why I went ahead and went to Walmart and picked up a couple different items. You can also buy these little pots at the dollar store. That's where I got these. They're 12 for a dollar. So there's a couple different ways that you guys can plant them based on, of course, where your budget lies. So I'll go over a couple different options that you guys can use and where to get those. So what I'm gonna be planting today, we have Roma tomatoes, love Roma tomatoes. I tried to get like a small plant that was already ready to go at Walmart, but they didn't have them. They only had the huge beefsteak tomatoes, which I absolutely hate because all that gooey stuff inside totally freaks me out. So I didn't want to do that. So all they had was the seeds. So I'm going to be planting some Roma tomatoes. Also have some green beans. We love fresh green beans. Sweet peppers. I already have a green pepper plant, so I'll show you guys that in a couple minutes, but I want some more sweet peppers. We love to put these in our eggs and a couple different dishes that we do. We have cilantro. I personally hate cilantro, but my boyfriend loves it, so I'm gonna plant him some cilantro. Carrots, love carrots. And squash. So that is what we are going to be planting today. The other thing that I bought, just to make it a little easier, is this. It's a growing kit. So it has all of these little pellets. You just add water to them, put the seeds in them, and then it's good to go. It's a lot easier than doing it the old-fashioned way, which of course you guys can do that as well. I just didn't want to get my hands all dirty because I don't have any gardening gloves. I forgot to pick some up, unfortunately. So one way you can buy these pots, again, they're 12 for a dollar. So you'd probably want to pick up at least two of these. They say to put at least about 3 to 5 seeds per pot. And where we're doing so many different ones, we're probably not going to use all the seeds that are in these. I'll save these for later in case any of them don't grow, or if any of them mess up, I'll have some extra seeds to kind of try it again. So you can do it this way. They do sell small bags, or like this big, of potting mix at Dollar Tree as well. Of course, they're just a dollar each. You'll want to grab a couple of those, especially if you're using this size pot. They had terracotta pots as well, a couple different sizes that you guys can choose from. And obviously they're all a dollar. So there were a ton of different flowers available at Dollar Tree as well. If you want to plant some nice flowers in your backyard or in a windowsill, anything like that, they had a lot of different options available. Let's go ahead and show you guys kind of what I have so far in my garden. I don't have a ton of things. Then we're going to go ahead and get these pellets growing. So I only have a few things in my garden. I have this green pepper plant, which I kind of brought back from the dead. It wasn't really doing well. And as you can see, I have forks in here because it, like, if you can see that, it, like, this branch split off, like it was falling off and it was gonna die. So I put that there, and then look, now it's growing a super cool green pepper. And then I have a big green pepper right here, which I'm really excited about. Then I have some parsley that I've had for quite a while, so I just make sure that I keep trimming it down, that way it'll grow more and more, and I think that's kind of cute. And then I just have this jalapeno plant. Look at my little baby jalapeno right here. I have some chives and some scallions as well in another pot, but that's literally all that I have at my house. With a lot of people homeschooling now and having their kids at home, I thought this could be a really cute project that you can do with your kids. Okay, so I opened this up. It comes with 25. There was another one you could buy that came with 72, but I bought the smaller one. I didn't think I was gonna need 72 of them. Also comes with this plant seed medium. So you just put it in a little spray bottle, mix it with some water, and then you spray it on top of it, and it helps feed the seeds and helps them grow quicker. And then of course, all of our instructions and everything are right here on the back. We have a pitcher of water, and I grabbed a little 1/4 cup measuring cup here because it's supposed to add 1/5 cup to each of these little pellets, and then they'll grow to about 1 to 1.5 inches. I have this on the side because once I read it, it says soak seeds overnight in warm water, and obviously it's during the day, so I'm gonna do this one at night. The other ones I will be doing today. So let's go ahead and start adding our water to the pellets and watching them grow. Okay, so pouring the water directly into the little container isn't working, so I'm gonna take a couple different solo cups here and put one of the pellets in each of the solo cups. That way I can put the right amount of water in them. Once they expand, I'll show that to you guys as it happens. Then I will put them back into that little tray. So let's go ahead and do that now. So it says 1/5, so I'm just filling it up this much. It's not exact, but that's okay. It doesn't have to be. So then I'm just gonna pour it right into my little solo cup, and that way it can start to absorb it. As you see, these two are already starting to expand and absorb the water. Once all the water is fully absorbed and it's as big as it possibly can be, they'll be about 1 to 1.5 inches tall. Then we're gonna put them back into the container that it came in. So when they're done, this is what it is going to look like. As you can see, it's about 1.5 inches tall, and then we are going to go ahead and fluff the top. So once it's fully absorbed and there's no more water in the cup, now I'm gonna go ahead and gently take it out so that I can put it into the container that it came in and line all those up. Then we can move on to our next step and start adding the seeds inside. So now that all of our little pellets have grown to be about 1 to 1.5 inches, and we put them all back in our pot, the next thing it says to do is to tear back the netting and fluff the top a little bit so we can go ahead and put the seeds inside. So let's do that now. Okay, so the next thing that I did after I fluffed up all of the pellets is I just kind of put my finger in the middle to make a little hole. That way I can put the seeds inside and then cover it softly with the remaining of the pellet. There are cracks underneath all of these pellets. That way when you water them, it will equally distribute the water to all of the pellets. That's why buying one of these kits is so great. Just makes it so much easier when you guys are planting a garden. So I also went ahead and labeled all of my pipes here, or stakes, or whatever you want to call them. So that way I won't get confused and I will remember exactly where I planted what, and they all do, of course, come apart. So let's go ahead and start planting these seeds. Open up. And each packet of seeds is gonna come with a different amount of seeds. So just keep that in mind. They're also gonna be different sizes. So what I do is I'm putting about 3 to 5 seeds in each of these little pellets. Then we're gonna go ahead and cover them with the remaining of the peat on the top. So because these are so big, I'm only putting like 2, maybe 3 in each because they're such large seeds. Okay, so we have all of our seeds planted. So now what we're gonna do is put the remaining of this that we had on top, and you wanna just lightly cover it. You don't wanna pack it down too much. That way the seeds can sprout through. So we're just gonna go through and cover up all of these seeds. These larger ones, of course, ooh, get over here, gonna be a little trickier to cover. If any of it kind of fell down in the middle, you can use that and just cover up all of the seeds. The next step, we are going to go ahead and make this Super Thrive plant vitamin for seedlings. So it says on the back to mix it in 1 gallon of water. I don't have anything that holds 1 gallon of water, so I just have this spray bottle here that I reuse. This is only 22 fluid ounces. There's 128 fluid ounces in 1 gallon. So we are just going to mix it proportionally, and then we are going to spray all of the different seedlings. You want to make sure that you don't overwater them, so just a couple spurts to make sure that it covers all of them. That way they all get that extra boost of plant food. Now the remaining directions say to cover it, then you're going to put it in a warm place. So let's go ahead and do that now. Okay, so now we are going to put the dome on top and we are going to place it in a warm place. I will do a post and show you guys photos as these continue to grow. I'm super excited and I can't wait to be able to eat all of these vegetables. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to give the video a big thumbs up. Share it with your friends and family, especially those who have kids. This was a nice quick little lesson and I'm sure the kids would all love it of different ages. Thank you guys so much and I will see you next time.